Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today, yes, it's another video for getting ready with me video. But the eyeshadow that I'm going to use is this e.l.f. one. This one right here. I know autumn is already over, but I just can't get enough of autumn. Though in our country, we don't have autumn season, but you can see some of our trees and plants have that kind of autumn feel, so yeah. Anyways, so I've already done my eyebrows, I've already also done my skincare routine, so if you wanna know how I did my eyebrows, just click on that annotation, or you can click the link below on the description box. Actually, these are all of my, some of my forgotten stash. Some were recently bought and some were basically old already, so yeah. And I'll be using kind of 1 to 2 products for just like in a part of my face to try some new kind of techniques. So yeah, testing this out, right? So I'll be doing my base, the primer. I'm using this L'Oreal True Match Blur Cream. I bought this 2 years ago, and after that I haven't used it since. I kind of like it, but this is what it looks like. So yeah, I try using my hands, but for now I don't feel like it. So probably I'll just use my foundation brush. Okay, just a sec. Okay, I'm back. So just gonna use foundation brush I've been using this week, which is the e.l.f. Ultimate Blending Brush. And then I'm going to use my foundation. This is the Max Factor Radiant Lift Long Lasting Radiance in Light Ivory. Okay, I'll put this at the back of my hand. I recently bought this, I think, a few months ago. And after that, I haven't used it since. I haven't tried it, so. I'll be shooting 2 videos tonight, so you're probably wondering, I might use the same top. I usually shoot 2 to 3 videos a day, so plus I think that's the only time. Sunday is my only time for YouTube videos that videos, editing them. So Sunday is my only free time. Monday to Saturday is our work, all about work, 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 and work. So let's put on, as I do have. This is a very light coverage. So, for those of you, who are, have a beautiful skin, this works for you. But for those who have blemishes, you know, acne, and don't have a beautiful, wonderful skin like me right now, I suggest you need 2 layers of this. Although this one's kind of available for me, but I don't know. I want. This is kind of slightly lighter than me, but I can pull it off. It's because of the bronzers. That's the use of bronzers if you can't use that, especially all over bronzer. Okay, for my facial concealment, I'm going to use this one. I bought this a few weeks ago and I haven't tried it yet, so this is the first time I'm going to try this. This is the L'Oreal True Match Super Blendable Crayon Concealer, and my shade is N123. And I'm going to let that set. So let's just go ahead with my eyeshadows. I'm going to use this one. These are all the samples of my Urban Decay Primer Potion. Okay, I'll just set it with a translucent powder, the NYC Smooth Skin Loose Face Powder, and my shade is translucent. And I'm gonna need just a tiny bit. This is EcoTools eyeshadow brush, so I'm just gonna need a tiny bit of this to set that thing, set my Urban Decay. Alright, for my eyes, I'm going to use this, the e.l.f. Bite Size eyeshadow. The shade is Truffles and Pumpkin Pie. And this will be, I'm going to use a fluffy brush. I'm going to use this, is the e.l.f. Blending Brush. And just the tip. And I'm going to use this kind of position, which is the flatter. I'm gonna put it on my crease and then change it to vertical position and blend all the way here. Make sure that the motion deeper here and suddenly blend it inwards. Honestly, this is the first time I'm going to use or to try putting on primer and then setting it with a translucent powder. I haven't tried that kind of technique, but this is the first time. So I do have a very oily lid. So what I usually do is put on primer and then base and then put on my eyeshadow. But this is the first time that I'm going to set my primer with a translucent powder. And I don't know if it would blend well. For me, it's kind of blended out. Both my eyes, this one, my right eye, is really easy to blendable because the under eyebrow brow bone here on my right side is not that pronounced. Well, this one is really pronounced, so as you can see, it's kind of, it's not that curved enough, so I have to kind of blend it until above the crease. Well, this one is really enough for blending. It has a beautiful kind of shape. This one is a little bit pronounced, so as you can see. Okay, and then I'm going to take this pumpkin pie. Now the same brush, which is this one, I'm going to take this matte shade right here. And I'm going to put this all over my lid. If you could hear outside some children, they are playing outside, running. We have lots of children in our neighborhood, so kind of fun. Sometimes it's kind of annoying because even late at night, like 8 in the evening and 9, they're still playing outside. Sometimes if you really want to shoot the video, you can't because it's too noisy. All you can hear is the laughter, the shouting, although it's good, but well, sometimes their laughter and the shouting are more louder than my voice, and I can't shout. So, but nevertheless, children are a pretty beautiful part of my life, though I haven't had one. Okay, now I'm going to clean this up. Using this, this is the Beauty Sensation color switch. So, yeah. Okay, I'm going to set this aside because I need it to the crease. Now I'm going to use my ring finger and I'm going to apply this one. On the top, the dabbing motion. And then from the truffles, what's this? Yeah, truffles. I'm going to take this top right here and using this elf blending brush again, just on the center. There. Now I'm going to take a very fluffy brush. This one, this is. I can't remember where I bought this thing, but. Blend without putting anything on. Next, I'm going to take from the truffles this dark brown right here, and I'm going to take this flat eyeshadow brush. Okay, I'm just going to use this and apply it along the lash line. Taking that fluffy brush again, blend. Just kind of blend. And then go back to your elf blending brush. And that's the time you kind of blend it further. Anything, the inner corner right there, kind of thing. Alright, elf pumpkin pie. I'm going to take this one right here, just a tiny bit. I'm gonna mix this two, this brown and this one, the darker shade. And this will be on my lower lash line. Take this black from the truffles, this one right here, a very dense angle brush, and this will be on the upper lash line. Children are playing. I don't know why, but this early morning I don't hear children playing. This early afternoon, like 2 to 3 in the afternoon, which is a little bit colder now, there's no more sun. They could have played it outside, well, I'm not shooting video, but they chose this kind of time. Might as well just enjoy my background noise. And then what's left on the brush, just dab it a little bit, just on the inner corner, right there. And then I'm going to make it a little bit darker on the outer corner, like this. Make it a little bit thicker. I'm going to take my flat brush, eyeshadow brush, which is this one from the dark, and I'll use this to blend the outer corner where I kind of deepen the shade black. Blend that to this, kind of push it. Blending of the black, the pumpkin shade, some softness. Now there's no under eyebrow highlight in this one, so I'm just gonna use my what I've been using. Going back to my foundation brush and blend. This is the CoverGirl and Olay Simply Ageless Corrector, and this one is in yellow. This is very yellow undertone, as you can see, so I prefer peach, but nevertheless, I'm going to combine something. I'm going to test some kind of testing something out. And taking this Real Techniques Deluxe Crease brush. I did mix the two. It used to be that kind of swirl with flesh color and a white one. But that's too yellow for me. So I guess I'll do something about it. Now don't blend too high. It's because what about your lower for your lower lash line? Okay, just a tiny bit. I'm using a tiny bit of concealer. Outside during night time, probably because the weather now is November 7th and it's the wind is breeze is getting colder and colder, and the children wants to play outside during night time because it's cold and they don't sweat a lot, so they have more time to play instead of going inside, because I know their mom would call them and tell them to take a shower because they're bathing in sweats. So playing, they love to run around like that. Okay. Alright, next one. I bought this a month ago, I guess. This is the Photo Focus Color Corrector from Wet n Wild, and this shade is peach. Now I don't know, it's not really that too peach, so I'm just gonna need a tiny drop. Oh, it is peach. Going back to my foundation brush, just kind of blend to set my under eye. Nothing new. I'm gonna use this Ben Nye Banana. This is my favorite under eye setting powder. set on face. This is the L'Oreal BB Veil. Veil Techniques Blush Brush. And I'm just gonna do a kind of stippling motion. So don't want to remove the concealer. Now I don't have all over bronzer since I'm too light on this, so never mind. Okay, for my bronzer contour, this is the MAC. What's this? Next to Nothing bronzer powder in Canyon Dream. Now I know this is a limited edition. I bought this during sale. So then MAC was having a sale. Lazada shop. This is a from Essential Tools. I bought this on eBay. So. I have this kind of a tapered brush. I don't know what is this or but I remember I bought this a few years ago. It's a set from Landmark. And I'm gonna put this and this. Then I'm going back to my fluffy brush and to my bronzer. And I'm gonna put this here as my transition shape. Blush, I'm going to take this L'Oreal Le Bar blush in Be Unique. Okay. Taking this angle brush from Daiso. I love this kind of brush from them. It's exact for my small cheeks and not too big, not too, you know, it's not going overboard. So it's kind of like a little bit darker. Just add. And then going back to my powder brush. Blend everything. Alright. For my highlight, this is the Revolution Makeup Revolution Highlighter Reloaded in Dare to Indulge. This one. I know this huge powder brush from Daiso, but just love it. Just use kind of it. This tops of blushing boots. Lightly. What's left? Now, I'm going to take on my little finger right here. And put this on the corner. Open my eye. Just turn it. Eyeshadow brush, which is from Tools. I'm gonna blend it. Then I'm going to set. I'm going to use this, the Beauty Bakery Clarifying Rich Hazel Facial Mist. Okay, then let's go with mascara. Eyelash curler. To be honest, I'm not a fan of mascara. I do have a very thin lashes, very knocked down lashes. Doesn't want to curl up. So by the end of the day, even before the end of an hour or two, I already have mascara smudges on my lower lash line. So yeah, I don't know what's wrong with my lashes. That's why sometimes I don't know where mascara goes off the bottom. Alright, I'm going to use Maybelline Falsies. I don't have a lot of mascara since, you know, I said I'm not a fan of mascara. So I only have quite a few, like 2 to 3 mascaras, 2 backups, and 1 I'm using right now. Because I'm not going to end up using them quite a lot. So yeah. I've been using a castor oil so that my lashes is taken care of. Whenever I apply mascara and then I remove them with a makeup remover, end up I do have fallouts of lashes because I'm not blessed with having beautiful lashes. So that's why I'm avoiding. Okay. Alright. Now let's go with the lips. This is Wet n Wild Color Icon in Brandywine. Still remember this. I saw this from Emily Noel in one of her old videos and kinda like it, so I told myself why not try it. Then I think this is the first time I'm going to use this. This is the Revlon Mac Balm in Enchanting. I bought this months ago. I haven't tried this, to be honest. I haven't tried it. I know I'm on a late login and I just bought this recently, so yeah. Oh yeah, there's peppermint in it. There's peppermint in it. Wow, I love it. There's peppermint. Okay. Anyways, so that's my getting ready with me video. Thank you very much, guys, for watching. If you're new to my channel, hi, my name is Anne. Welcome to my channel. Don't forget to subscribe. If you like this video, give a thumbs up. And for those who are already my subscribers, don't forget to click the bell button so that you'll be notified whenever I upload a video. I always upload once a week, either by Sunday or Monday, either of the two. Depends on my editing. So, yeah, that is it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. God bless. Bye. Take care. See you. Bye.